Sitting on the launch pad is definitely a moment that you're always thinking about, right? That's one of the more critical phases of the flight, as you can imagine. You're very focused in, right? It can be a very emotional time. You're kind of pinching yourself because it's hard to believe that you're finally there.
Born in Lebanon, Missouri, he is an Air Force colonel and a flight test engineer. He was selected as an astronaut in 2009. He spent 166 days on the International Space Station, introducing NASA astronaut Mike Hopkins.
You know, it's funny, I mean, a lot of times people think of the dream of being an astronaut as something that a kid would have. And I remember when my wife and I first started dating at the University of Illinois and I told her that I wanted to be an astronaut, she laughed at me and kind of said, "Are you serious?" But at the same time, she stuck with me throughout the years, and to have that dream come true is pretty amazing. My role on the Crew Dragon itself as part of Crew-1 is the commander of the vehicle. We'll be launching to the International Space Station, and we're going to be doing a long-duration mission, a standard long-duration mission. One of the nice things about being on board the International Space Station is you have a lot of connectivity, believe it or not, with your family. And so I was able to call just about every day. My family means everything to me. It is the most important part of my life. My wife Julie, my son Ryan, my son Lucas, they are just such a huge part of this whole endeavor. You know, without family, it just wouldn't be as meaningful. The partnership that we have right now with SpaceX, it's pretty powerful. They bring a lot to the table. NASA brings a lot to the table. We've got a ton of experience in human spaceflight. When you're out there on a day-to-day basis and you're interacting with their engineers and you're interacting with their trainers and you're interacting with the people that are actually building the rockets and building the capsule itself, you really get to establish the relationships, the personal relationships. It's not just about the astronauts that are on board, but it's about the entire team at NASA and SpaceX that it's taken to launch this Crew-1 vehicle, and we couldn't do our job without them.